Welcome everyone.
Hey Yvette.
Hey Joe.
Wow, do we have a jam-packed T4L show in store for you?
I can't believe we're already on the second episode of the year. We've had so much going on, and this show again is jam-packed.
We're talking drones. Yvette, you've been on the road speaking to all of our partners.
I know, we've got some great stuff to show you from Microsoft and Google.
And of course, Stu's News is a feature as always.
That's right, but first of all, we're gonna take a look at where we've been most recently.
And that is Interacted out at Wagga Wagga.
Are you keen to learn more about technology in the classroom? If you're a New South Wales public school teacher, you might want to come along to Interact Ed, which is a great day of professional learning for all levels of teachers.
Meeting all the different people and the vendors here, asking questions, just having the tech gurus here is really good. You can ask them the questions that you probably don't want to send in a million emails. Ask them in one go and get your answer straight away.
Coming to this event today allows me to further develop my own professional learning in where I can take what I know now into the future.
I found Interacted really a great opportunity to connect, so then when you're away from Interacted, you've got those people to talk to and share ideas with.
This has been Interacted Wagga Wagga, and it's a wrap.
Wagga Wagga was fantastic. It was great to meet the teachers out there from that region, and I know that it was a really helpful session for so many of you. We hope to see you at our next one at Taronga Zoo on May 7th.
Now, Yvette, I was just thinking, the old iPhone 3G, how many years old do you reckon it is?
I don't know.
10 years what? Old. 10 years ago, Barack Obama was elected. And you know what else is 10 years old or even older? It's Windows 7. If you're still on Windows 7, you need to listen in to Stu's News now.
Well, it's been another busy term. 2019, term one is all finished. One of the big changes that we see happening is something that's going to affect all of our schools. Since 2010, we've been rolling out Windows 7 to computers. And it's time for that to all change. We need to get away from Windows 7. Microsoft has stopped supporting it, or they're about to stop supporting it, and we need to get all of our devices off that platform and onto Windows 10. And in fact, since the T4L rollout of last year, you haven't been able to build anything but 1709. So it's something that a lot of schools have already got in place. It's working very nicely for them. But we've still got this big fleet of older devices that are running Windows 7, and we need to get those off Windows 7 as soon as possible. So something you really need to start planning for. Think about how you could maybe identify where those Windows 7 computers are in your school. The HP 360 is something that you're all very familiar with. HP have run out of stock of those, and there are many schools that have placed orders for them, but they've ceased allowing schools to place new orders for the HP ProBook 11 X360 model. HP are looking at releasing a new model of this particular laptop. Hopefully we'll see that around about the May-June timeframe. Beyond that, this term is coming up with some great content for newsletters, so keep an eye out in weeks 3, 6 and 9 for news.t4l and in week 5 for technology news for schools. Thanks very much.
Some amazing gems as always. Thank you so much, Stu. And don't forget, make sure you sign up to T4L News so you get all the gossip in advance.
Well, remember how we wanted everyone to make this their year of tech? It's my year of tech. It's your year of tech.
Absolutely.
And right now we're going to hear from Megan at Microsoft, who's going to talk us through some professional learning options.
Welcome to this episode of T4L TV. I'm Megan Towns from Microsoft. Let's explore how you can start your professional learning journey with Microsoft technologies and race ahead.
Thank you.
5 of them, because some amazing potential for you out there in your classrooms. So the first one is the new addition to what we call learning tools. So learning tools allows you to do all sorts of fabulous things in regards to supporting reading and comprehension. But now you can actually click on the third icon and use a translation tool as well, which is great for English language learners, as well as students learning another language in their subjects as well. So click the book icon, click on translate, and you're off and away and choosing from more than 30 languages, which is absolutely amazing. The second feature comes from a Windows app, and we'll be talking about Windows apps in a future episode. We have the Photos app inside of Windows 10. And when you're in the Photos app, you can bring your pictures and videos together to really easily edit videos. And you'll be able to choose from different themes and easily add music and text, and even better, some 3D effects, which is awesome. Then we have Microsoft Teams, the fastest growing product for Microsoft, but also within Department of Education as well. So a feature that has been requested extensively since Teams was launched a couple of years ago is read-only files for students in their class teams. So you'll be able to access your team, click on files in the general channel, and you will see a folder called class materials. And everything you place in there as a teacher is read-only. Absolutely great feature that's been requested by teachers worldwide. Then we have the Microsoft Whiteboard EDU app. So again, another app available through the App Store. You can actually create interactive whiteboards using your own interactive hardware. But the great thing about it is you can actually share those whiteboards with your students and have them collaborate in live time. So whether you're using a board at the front of the room or whether you're just using Windows 10 devices, you can collaborate in real time on the whiteboard app, which is awesome. And then finally, the Microsoft Education YouTube channel is always being added to, and you'll actually find videos on there quite regularly called What's New in EDU. So check that YouTube channel out for all the greatest things that are coming to Microsoft right now and in the year ahead. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to look for the bag with the Microsoft logo and download your apps today.
Cool stuff there from Megan. Right now we're going to take a look at some updates on the STEMshare library from Michelle.
Hi everyone, Michelle Michael from STEMshare Community here, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about the STEMshare Community Learning Library. If you haven't been onto that learning library yet, get on there now, because it's actually the cycle of how you can book your kit, how to prepare for your STEMshare Community kit, and all the resources that are linked to syllabus outcomes and your teaching and learning in classrooms in New South Wales. The best way to find the learning library is on your learning tools under your new portal. If you click on learning tools, you'll see one of the bars there is the STEMshare Community Learning Library. Click on that library and you'll be able to work your way through some of the amazing resources that we've developed to support you and your students when you're using the STEMshare Community kits in your classroom. Some of the great parts of the learning library include being able to search by kit for resources and also by stage for resources. So get on there, have a look at the learning library for STEMshare Community, and we hope you love it as much as we've enjoyed putting it together for you.
Wow, I can tell you I'm blown away by this new STEMshare library, and my favourite feature has to be the ability to create your own board. So make sure you get out there, create a board today, and share it with your colleagues. What's next, Yvette?
We're going to be talking about drones.
Oh, controversial, hey?
No, but not really.
No, exactly right. We found a way around it, haven't we?
We did. We're going to hear from Greig now, who's going to give us an update.
Hi everyone. If you're looking behind me, you can probably work out this is all about drones. Drones are a very new item or a tech item that schools are starting to use, so we need to comply to a few things. CASA is our Civil Aviation Authority, and we need to comply to their rules, and it's very, very important that we do that. Drones from any weight right up through to 150 kilos fall under their jurisdiction, and we need to make sure that we're following those rules. Get onto the CASA website and have a look at the rules there, and make sure that when you are actually looking at those rules that you interpret them correctly. as a teacher, you fall under the recreational side of it, not the commercial side of it. We're not doing it for gain or profit. So we can actually fly under those rules. There's a few rules that we need to look at with our kids, and safety is always the most important thing that we need to look at. The 30 metre rule is still required, but we can get around a few things as long as we've got some safety involved, like safety glasses, cages around drones, etc. The drones that we're looking at using in schools at the moment will be the little sub 100 gram drones, for example, things like the little Tello DJI drone. And these are a really, really nice little drone with a programming environment, and that's one of the things that we're trying to get the kids doing, programming for their drones. Safety that we need to look at is for kids in classrooms. You need to be looking at safety glasses, keeping the kids controlled, away from the flight zones, basically have a flight controller when you're flying your drones. If you can put a physical barrier between the kids and the drones, like a net example, again, a very, very good way of making sure that you're reducing your hazards as much as possible. If you're starting to look at larger drones, you may be in a position where you need to look at getting approval to fly them. And come July 1st, you are going to need to get your 250 gram and up drones registered. So that will be a cost for most schools that they will need to consider if they're going to actually fly them. After the 1st of July, also 16 years and above, students and teachers will need to be licensed to fly drones as well. And from my understanding from the rules, that is all drones.
Some great advice there from Greig, which really empowers you to consider the use of drones in your classroom.
And I hope you get off the ground.
I love it.
Have you ever wondered what really happens at Google? Lucky us, we got down to the Google headquarters in Sydney and we're exploring some of the new features coming out of Google.
I'm Richard. I've worked at Google for about 3.5 years. My role entails that I look after the Department of Education from a technical perspective, so I work across all the technical teams, from architecture to support, and make sure that all the Google products are running fine for schools. So we have great new feature updates for Classroom and Drive. With Classroom, we have the new auto-grading feature, so they don't have to spend a lot of time marking different students' grades. So one of the great other features that we've got is locked quizzes. What that means is that if you're using a lockdown Chromebook, you can actually make a quiz full screen so that students can't access anything else while they're doing their quiz. If you combine that with the auto-grading feature, that means that teachers have a really powerful tool to make sure that students are doing the quiz and the auto-grading is happening at the same time, saving them time and the students access to the quiz as well. Great powerful feature for both students and teachers. I love working at Google because we have a great view and we have great food upstairs, but also it's the team. It's all about the culture working at Google. I have a great team that I work with. I love the work that they do. We all specialize in our different areas and we all upskill ourselves at the same time.
We had such a fun day filming out at Google. That video was great to put together. But speaking of putting videos together,
we want to see your submissions to the T4L Awards. Here's how.
Every day, amazing things are happening in schools with the utilisation of technology. And we'd like to share some of those stories, particularly through our T4L Awards. If you're doing amazing things, please send us a 3-minute video of what you're doing in your school and join us for the T4L Awards. Applications close May 31st. So get in quick and share your amazing tale.
T4L Awards are going to be amazing. I can't wait to see what you guys produce. However, it's not the only thing we're working on.
No, the next big event we've got is Interacted at Taronga Zoo, where STEM and tech go wild. Let's take a peek. So, if you can't make it to Taronga Zoo, don't worry. We've got two other events, one in Wollongong on the 18th of June, and then the other in Newcastle on the 3rd of July. We are all over New South Wales this term too.
Is that a wrap?
It is a wrap. Oh my gosh. Episode 2 for 2019 is done. Don't forget, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. Get everyone else to subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're doing something exciting, hashtag T4L. Catch you next time. Hey, Vex.
Hey, Joe.
Wow.
Hardship to go out to Google and shoot that video. Why was that so funny?
Welcome, everyone. Wow. Hey, Vex.
Hey, Joe.
Wow. No, you've got the giggles.
Sorry, we can't do that.
This is not good. Do we have another awesome jam-packed T4L in store?
In store
for you. Absolutely.
It's
a cool one though. I really like that
guys,
though.
Wow. Well, some professional learning options.
Oh, bang
guys.
On. Come on, pull yourself together.
Just making it work.
Wow.
Okay, all right, let's get rid of the giggles.
Wow.
So into
bring in the cheese.
Yeah,
bring
yeah.
in the cheese.
Yeah. Okay, and then we're going.
Year of tech.
Year of tech too.
Joe, come on. Okay.
We're grown adults and we can't stop laughing. Woo.
That's right.
Love it. All right, okay. So.